Hi, this is Sriyank Siddhartha and welcome to another video on Kotlin programming. Now, in one of my previous video, I have talked about what is backing field in Kotlin, which is closely related to what we are going to explore in this video, that is backing property. So if you haven't seen that video, then please see that video first. The link is in the description. So in this video, I will talk about backing property in Kotlin. So we are going to start with the basics of backing property. What is it all about and why it is used in Kotlin. And along with this, we will also see a practical example of backing property of how you can use it in your Kotlin project. Now, these days in Android, we quite often use backing property in our Android application while developing it. So from the Android perspective, we will also see an example of where we can use the backing property in Android. And of course, before you start this video, if you are new, please subscribe to my channel and give this video a big thumbs up. So let's get started. Let us start with what is backing property and what problem does it solve? So suppose we have a class human, and inside this class, we have a property of age. Now in Kotlin, by default, a property is public in nature. So even if you don't specify this property as public, then also it is by default public in nature. This is something we should know from Kotlin fundamentals. Now since this property is public, so it is exposed outside this class of human. So anyone having the access to its class object can modify the value of age property. For example, outside this class within main function, we can create human instance, access the age property, and set its value by calling its default setter method. And again, access the age, get the value by calling its default getter method, and print the value. So here is the output. But from the security perspective, if you notice, this age property is exposed outside the class, and anyone can modify this property, and this could raise security concerns in some part of the application, of course. So what is the solution for this? How can we further encapsulate our property variable and safeguard it from the outside world? So here comes the backing property into the picture. So let us see an alternative code using the concept of backing property. The syntax is again very simple. All you have to do is change this default public to private and add an underscore before the name age. Something like this. So this public becomes private over here and we added an underscore before the property name. Next, you need to declare another variable such as var age. And by default, this will be public in nature, even if you don't specify it. Then define its getter function. Notice here that this getter returns underscore age, which is this private field over here. Why? We will see to that in a moment. Then we define its custom setter. Again, notice that we are using underscore age private field. Now, this underscore age private property is actually known as the backing field in Kotlin. And the purpose of this backing field is to hold the value of the actual age property. So please note this, this is important. And if you want to know more about the backing field, then I have a separate video on this topic. Please check the link in the description. Then this public var age is actually known as the backing property. So this is what is known as backing property on which our video is based upon. And since this backing property is public, so it is this backing property which will be exposed to the outside world. Then in its getter, we return underscore age. Why? Because underscore age, which is over here, is the backing field. And it represents the value of our actual age property. So that is why we return underscore age over here. The same applies for the setter as well. We use backing field underscore age and set the value to it. So remember, within the class human, you should always use the backing field whenever you want to access the value of the age property, like we are doing here and here. And we only use this var age to access the property value outside this class, not inside the class. Now, this entire code over here using the backing property is exactly same as the old code over here at the top. So you can just pause the video and take a closer look at them. Now, what about the code within the main function? Will there be any changes over here? Well, the answer is no. Because as said, this code and this code are exactly the same for the outside world. Let's see how. So within our main function, we create the human instance. And we call its setter method, which executes this set method over here. And this set method in turn sets the underscore age as 45, right? Then we call human.age, which executes its getter, which is over here. Now the getter method returns the underscore age, which is 45, right? So in the output, we will get the same result. So for the outside world, this code and this code is exactly the same. The only difference is this code is more encapsulated and has greater security. Now in the end, please note one more thing. Within the class human, you should always use underscore age field to access the original property value, like we are doing in our getter method over here and in the setter method over here. So within the same class, always use this backing field to update, modify, or do some operations. But outside the class, you should only use age, which is our backing property, to access the property value, like we are doing in our main function, that is in the outside world. Fine, so again, please note this point. This is again very important. So let's take a couple of more code examples to understand backing property better. Let's see a practical example in Kotlin itself. So we have a class student and a property of hobbies, which is of course by default public in nature. And notice here that this is basically a mutable list of string, which is mutable in nature. Then within this class, we have a function addHobby, whose purpose is to add a new hobby object to the hobbies list whenever this function is executed. So when we use this code in our application, such as within our main function like this, we can create a student object and call addHobby method by passing a hobby into it. So this will execute this function over here and add a new hobby to the hobbies list. But our application requirement is as such that we don't want any external agent to accidentally delete a hobby from this list. For example, if suppose any developer accidentally write this code, such as student.hobbies.remove method. So this will access our hobbies property directly and therefore delete a hobby object. So this accidental deletion of the object will lead to disaster, right? So we don't want such accidental deletion of data. But because our property is public as well as mutable, so such accidental disaster is quite possible. So how to avoid such issue? So the solution lies in the usage of backing property in Kotlin. So for that, first, we need to create a backing field by changing this public to private and adding an underscore before its name, like this. Also note that I have not changed the original implementation of this object. The mutable list of string remains the same. So here again, you can remember the original implementation of the object always remains the same in case of backing field. It does not change. Then we can create its backing property, which is by default public. And within its getter, it returns the backing field. Now notice here that I have changed its implementation over here. It is just a list of string and it is of type val. So this means that it is immutable in nature. So that is why we don't have any setter method for this backing property. Now because it is public in nature, so the outside world can access this backing property, but because it is immutable in nature, so the outside world cannot modify it directly. So this fits into our application requirement. Now moving on, then we can have our function addHobby the way it was, but with a slight difference. Here we are using underscore hobbies instead of hobbies. And from the previous demo, we know that within the same class, you should always use the backing field to access the property value. So this is what I am doing here. I have just changed this hobbies to underscore hobbies. Now in the main function, as usual, the code would remain the same. So this part and this part is exactly the same. But we were facing issue with the accidental damage, right? So here, if you try to access and change the property like this way, then this code is not going to compile this time. Because this hobbies is immutable in nature now. So you cannot call remove function or do any such kind of modification on an immutable object. So there is no chance a developer would accidentally do this disaster. So this way, by using backing property, once again we have added a secured layer of data encapsulation. Perfect. So I hope you understood this example. Now moving on, after Kotlin, let us see a practical example in case of Android. Now if you are an Android developer, then you must have used a ViewModel class. A typical ViewModel contains data which can be used to display something on screen, using activity or fragment of course. Suppose we have a class GameViewModel, and inside this class, we have a property score, which is public of course, and also mutable in nature. Then we have incrementScore function, which increments the score value. And we have decrementScore function, which decrements the score value. Now, to use them inside the UI layer, such as inside an activity or a fragment, first we can create the instance of GameViewModel and then call increment or decrement methods accordingly. But here is a catch. In Android, we follow some rules for greater good. The properties inside the ViewModel should only be modified inside the ViewModel class itself. And this is what we are doing here in our case, such as we are incrementing and decrementing the score value within the functions defined within the class itself. But since the score property is public and mutable in nature, so there is a chance that outside this class, we can accidentally increment or decrement the score value directly using the property itself, which is not right and should always be avoided in Android. So what is the solution for this? So again, the solution is the usage of the backing property. So here we have done nothing new. This is our backing field, which is private and with an underscore. This is our backing property, which is public but immutable to the outside world. Then we have these two functions, which remains the same, but instead of actual property name, now we use backing field using an underscore. Fine. So now this code over here will never succeed. That is, it won't compile, which means there is no way someone would even accidentally write this code, thus safeguarding our score property. So in this way, in Android, you can encapsulate your property using the concept of backing property. Nice and simple. So yes, that's all about backing property. So to summarize this video in just one line, the purpose of backing property is just to encapsulate your property variable in your class and safeguard it from the outside world, right? So in this video, we have seen one practical example of how to use it in Kotlin, as well as one example from the Android perspective. So I hope you have learned something out from this video. So to support this video, please drop a comment in the comment box below and give this video a thumbs up. And if you're new to this channel, then do subscribe. This is Sriyank Siddhartha signing off, and thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Thank you.